Hey guys, welcome back. So guys, in this video we are going to continue the edit and update things. So guys, in previous video we have completed how to edit and fetch the data into a text box, and now in this video we will complete this to update the data also. Okay, so let's get started. So as simple, we were on the edit page blade file to update the file, update the data. So guys, now first step, you have to check out everything is set. So you are passing the form. So after this, you have to pass the ID also. So dollar category ID. Okay. So you can fetch that whatever the variable you have sent from your controller. So same thing you have to call, and call that ID. Right. Save it. And now call these two things. One is token and one is method field, that is put. After this, and one submit button, update button is there, input type submit, that's it we required in this. Great. And now we'll copy this route and go to web.php. So this is our route, as you can see in the folder structure, route web.php. Over here we will set the route for updating the data. So route script resolution put method we have to call, because we are updating with the using put method, and give a forward slash and use the ID over here. And now go to one controller, that is category controller. I'll just copy this, and now you can hit on update. Go to category controller, let's create a function, public function update over here, and now let's call the things to get submitted. So over here when you click on update, so almost is saving things and updating things, so you can call that code of save things, right? So I'm just going to copy that same thing. If you are a continued watching user, you can understand this, what I'm going to copy and paste that same thing and edit the few things, right? So let us set the request also. REQUEST, request, dollar request. Dollar request, comma, and dollar ID also. That's it. After this, we have to set the find and save it. So let us put find and dollar ID will pass it. Simple. So once set, saved, and then take the group ID, name, description. Let's remove this unwanted things. Same thing. And then guys, what we have to do, search the path of it. Okay. So for that, like, you should match the datas, whatever it is coming from it. For example, this is the group ID, name, description, then your category image, category icon, and the status. So all these fields should match in your name, description, then category image, category icon, and then status, right? So this thing should be make sure it is available. And now, for example, in this we have few changes, right? So for that, we will be doing, like, see here, there is an already image, so this is stored somewhere, right? So for this, what we are storing over here, it's inside this folder fabcart. Okay, so inside public uploads, you can see category image. So category image, there is one image, right? So this image should be removed and then updated with the new image, right? So that also we have to do. So for that, we will start with it. So simple dollar designation will tell, or file path, whatever file path, you can tell, is equal to call the path name from it. So the path is like, what we are going to do is that category, call it dollar, and then so we have to concatenate that dollar category of image. Okay, so guys, category, oops, control Z. So category of image, whatever you are storing it, so that image path should be called. Okay, so after this we'll put a simple if statement to check whether that file is existing or not. So let's use file colon exists, exists the path. Okay, so if the file is existing, we will check with that file path, then file colon delete function, where we will set this path also. Simple. Now if you are using this file, make sure you are including at the top. So let's use that file, use file colon, simple, saved. And then now let's execute this. It's still showing error, but it will not do anything. Okay, so I think there is some plugin problem with this, so it's showing me like this, or else you can import the original file, or if you just required use this file, use file, it's more than enough. Okay, so it's fine with this. And now guys, same thing you have to apply for this also. So copy this condition and paste for the icon also, right? So let's paste that, and instead that call your update folder category icon, and instead of image you have to call your database column name, table column name, that is icon, and then file path. Instead of giving two things, so this may get clashed. So what you will tell is as image file, file path image. So let's give a unique name for it, so it may not get clashed. ICON icon, paste, save it. That's it guys. Now let us save this and upload and check whether it's getting updated. So after, you have to change this name also, update, and then back and sell updated successfully. Great. To show this message status, you have already over here, like in a simple if statement, I have just updated with this. That's it. Let's save it, reload the page, control R, and now we will update. So instead of mobile and accessories, we will give only mobiles. Let's save. And let's replace the image also. Instead of mobile, I'm going to replace some other image. Like you can just, okay, let's take this blue image something. Let's update it. Click on update. After, let's see, it's come error or it's getting solved. Cool. Category updated successfully. And the image also has been changed, and the data also has been updated with the electronic default thing. So now let's get back. I mean, let's go to the category main part and see everything is working fine. Yes guys, so the data also is updated. So now let's update back to the how it was. Okay, so instead of mobile, let's tell mobile and accessories, and now we will change the image also, because it is mobile thing. So for that, I just want to show you one more thing. We have changed, right? So let's see that folder also is changed or not. Okay, so like inside your fab cart, you can watch out public uploads category image. Okay, so you can see here that image is deleted and only this image is found. So for that, now let us update new image. So let's go to downloads. Download, you can see the mobile. Open it and let's update. So once updated, we'll check. Okay, category updated successfully. You can see that image also is changed. And let's go and see into our here, guys. So it's changed over here right now. So you can change the number, see the number also. Right now it is updated. Okay, so guys, thank you for watching this video, and we have learnt about how to update the data and change the image and delete the old image from the directory and update with the new image. Okay, so thank you for watching this video, guys. Let's continue in next video about how to delete the data and store its history also. Okay, so this deleting part will complete, and we'll complete this color category series and then start with the new one, subcategory and product items.